of 20% will go according to shareholding. So these are the details that Nairobians must understand.
The other one
is the collection of revenue.
Yes.
We are not giving our statutory authority to anybody to collect revenue on our behalf. We are going to enforce the collection of revenue,
yes,
but into a special account.
Right.
That's all.
Just explain that, that.
We are going to enforce the collection of revenue as a council,
yes,
but into a special account. Revenue from advertisement,
yes,
will be directed towards a certain account.
This that escrow is the account.
Escrow account.
Yes, but who will be collecting the revenue?
It is the council.
Not this new company.
Not the new company.
Right.
The council collects the revenue,
right,
enforces the law,
yes,
that people pay into that account.
Yes. So really, this new company is really just a managing agent.
Exactly.
So we are working together infrastructure
to put up infrastructure.
Right.
So these are issues that must be very correctly understood.
Right.
The other issue is of monopoly.
Yes.
We are not giving monopoly to anybody.
No.
What we are saying is, all the advertisers, all those companies who do advertisements.
Yes.
What we are telling them is, now there is this account. All your licenses must be paid into this account.
Through the new company, into the account. Yes.
Then you must continue doing business. You must continue advertising. You must continue doing, and even today, Mushiri, if you want to form a company to advertise,
yes,
we'll only give you the account number or the details of the account. Then we
Who will be regulating the issuance of license?
The council. The council.
So what is this company doing?
The company is only taking
those funds and building the streetlights.
And building
understood,
the streetlights.
Esther. Yes. What were your issues?
You know, I've known Mheshimiwa Wenje. In fact, I'm lighting up Mombasa Road, which is his constituency.
Yes.
And we have met on a few times, and he's complimented me and said, you know, you're doing a good job. So I find it very difficult at this stage to understand where he's coming from, because
yes,
all of a sudden, the contract that he knows has been around for the last 2 years, we've lit 50% of Mombasa Road,
yes,
and it's his constituency, and he's benefiting from it. And so are his members. And all of a sudden, this contract has become an issue today when it's being enhanced.
Yes.
Before, the contract, the way it was, we had an exclusive on every street that we were at.
Yes.
And the council went to the drawing board and said, look, we want to take ownership of this contract.
Yes.
We want to take ownership of this project. We are partners, but we don't have a benefit, a financial benefit. And that's what actually brought us to the negotiating table where the council would
to
have
review
a benefit.
The old contract.
Yes, because you see, the council wanted to own it
I've
as well.
I've got the Honorable Mauka Maure online. Yes, Mheshimiwa.
Yes, Mheshimi.
Yes.
I want to direct my question to His Worship, the Mayor of Nairobi.
Yes.
Whether he feels that since the City Council is unable to enforce its own rules and regulations to make the advertisers pay.
Yes.
This one given on top of the other one of Jakoroso for the collecting of garbage. Now, are we in a situation where we would ask the opinion of the mayor, whether he would support the dissolution of the City Council of Nairobi, and then it's run by a commission.
But Mheshimiwa, if I can come to his aid before you go off.
Yeah.
The whole question of privatization of services in order to improve service delivery is not a new concept to you, surely.
To talk of privatization, which is based on law and on policy.
Right.
Now, we are not getting any law or a policy which is guiding these people in their crusade for any privatizations they are talking about.
But what is the greater good, Mheshimiwa? Lights or no lights? While we wait for the rest of you to get your act together and give us a policy.
The city consumers of darkness or light have a contract with the city hall.
Right.
When they send those powers to a private entity, it is the one we are asking whether it is unenforceable. If they are themselves unable to enforce the people who advertise on these billboards,
right,
to collect revenue,
right,
what powers have they ceded to adapt a light so that the company can be able to enforce and have it paid? Can you support the dissolution of the council?
Thank you, Mheshimiwa.
And actually, I would want to support Maoka.
Can I take one last call, then you can talk?
Okay.
Okora. Yes, Okora? I think that's gone. Mathenge? Hello,
Mushiri and yes, the panel.
Yes.
But Mushiri, I think this country needs to take a breather. We are really heading in a very dangerous direction.
Yes.
We had Tato Coffee, you know the story.
Yes.
Now, I have no quarrel with Adapter Light.
Yes.
But the council, because of their mismanagement in the road.
Yes.
are really losing it. Here we have a lady who has been given a blank check.
Yes.
To do whatever she can. And the mayor, I'm really disappointed by the mayor.
Thank you very much, Madenge. Yes,
well, what I was saying, those two gentlemen are saying something of a lot of sense.
Yes.
If the council has now failed to do its work.
Yes.
You know, the other day it was water.
Yes.
The water went to Nairobi Water Company.
Yes.
Now the garbage is being done by private companies.
Yes.
The council seems now, the lighting and everything seem now to be going to other individuals in the wrong way.
Yes.
Collection of revenue is now going to different people.
Yes.
You see, if then I think Maoka Maore is right, then we should dissolve the council.
Yes.
Because then there is no purpose for the council.
Right.
And you know, even with all these letters,
yes,
and that's why I'm quoting with evidence that I have.
Yes.
There was even a letter,
yes,
which was written by the former permanent secretary,
yes,
to the former town clerk,
yes,
saying clearly, talking about this adopter light,
yes,
clearly, and talking and saying that it has been brought to the attention.
You can't read the whole letter.
I cannot read the whole of it.
No.
But it says it is apparent that there are underhand dealings going on in the council to deny the council revenue from advertising. Because there is no other logic explanation as to why they are going to give up upper light.
I want to go
to the contract because I feel this is important.
No, I'm going into a break, Mushmira.
I'm the chairman here. Just before you go to the break.
No, I am going to the break.
Take it.
We're going into the break, Betty. Relax. We need to come back and look at the court orders in the last 3 months and why the City Council seems to be ignoring this on Up Close and Candid.
And Candid. Up Close and Candid.
This is not a storm in a teacup, I can tell you that. Your Worship, you needed to speak back to Madenge and the Honorable Maoka Maore.
Now, as a serious manager of affairs in City Hall, and I want to believe that I am a serious person, and I want to look at the weaknesses of the institution to deliver services, then we need to expand the institutional capacity. That one goes without saying, because everybody is complaining that the infrastructure that was put down those years was to serve a certain number of people. It has expanded, and therefore we must look forward and be progressive. What we are saying is to improve on the institutional capacity, then we have to bring in private sector players, and we are in the process expanding the institutional capacity. Therefore, bringing in a player, partnering so that we move into that direction. Tomorrow we bring in another, we move into markets, we move into other areas so that we can be able to improve the institutional capacity. That doesn't mean we are giving up our statutory authority. We are not. We are controlling and we are regulating these people. So therefore,
which is where Esther comes in,
yeah.
Your Worship. Is why then is the Outdoor Private Practitioners Association against this process, if it's going to make business easier?
I'll tell you what, I think it's because they're thinking in a box. What's happening is, if His Worship can confirm this, the revenue from advertising, we all know, and they've said it themselves, oh, it's going to be big and she's going to make a lot of money. But the revenue from advertising, the council has never been able to realize more than 5 to 7% of its potential. Now, what we're saying is, if you want us to use advertising to light up Nairobi, then we need to start right there. Where is the problem? Why don't we have the revenue? Let's streamline that collection center. Let's computerize it.
Are you
Let's
saying that the current practitioners are not paying?
They are not paying. 10% maximum, and even that is a high perception. So we have to actually get that revenue up so that we can light up. Mombasa Road stalled.
Yes.
Immediately after we started, because there were structures coming up. The revenue was going to the council, but partially, 10%. And with 10%, where the potential is 2 billion and you're only collecting 130
but that, but,
million.
But does this deal give you undue advantage over the other practitioners?
No, what is going to happen? You see, you have to understand, the whole concept of adopter light is using advertising for street lighting.
Understood.
So what's going to happen is, we're going to actually relinquish selling.